welcome to another edition of High Life Outreach Ministries. My name is Carl Taylor, my beautifully lovely wife, Charity Taylor, here. Amen. We've been married 22 years. This year will be 33 years.
You said 22. It's 32.
32 years.
That's right. And amen. It'll be 33 this May.
That's right. I'm trying to go backwards now. Yeah. Don't mess up now.
Doesn't seem like it's been that long.
It doesn't seem that long, though, but we've been having a good time. She loved me through the bad time, rough time, and all in between times, right? Praise God. And we just thank God for what God is doing in your life also through That's this right. ministry. Please continue to give to the ministry. Praise God. I desire to take this message worldwide that somebody's marriage may be healed. Somebody may be saved, healed, delivered, and set free. Yeah. It's time for the body of Christ to really to begin examining their own personal life and also their family life.
Yes.
We tell ministries and pastors and we let them know. I say, listen, your family is the foundation of your ministry.
Yes.
So make sure your foundation is proper before you build that house.
That's right.
Amen. That's right. Let's pray before I start preaching, baby. Isn't that right?
Amen.
Father, we just thank you, God, for the Holy Spirit of God. Thank you, God, for the marriage union, God. We thank you, God, for the ordinance, God. Lord, in Jesus' name, and all our partners out there, God, Father, we decree a special blessing over their life and family in Jesus' name, that they may be bold in their ministries and their communication, God, and bold in pressing forward to the mark of the high prize and calling of God, which is in Christ Jesus. And we thank you for them this day, God.
Yes.
We bless them today, God, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 We're still on this series called God's Plan for the Marriage Bed.
That's right. It's Valentine's coming up.
Valentine's is coming up, right?
It's a good topic to share with your spouse or with your friends. This is an important subject that we believe really needs to be shared.
It does.
So tune in. Ask your family members to tune in. If you want to sit down and rewatch the broadcast together, you can. We're on YouTube, so this will be a blessing for those of you.
We got clips on Facebook,
that's
too.
Right. That's right. So share this with those that you know will be blessed. And we're going to start out with our very first scripture in Hebrews 13, verse 4. It says, let marriage be held in honor, esteemed worthy, precious, of great price. And I'm reading from the Amplified PC version. Understand this, which is a classic edition. It says, let marriage be held in honor, esteemed worthy of precious, of great price, and especially dear in all things, and thus let the marriage bed be undefiled, kept undishonored, for God will judge and punish the unchaste. And all guilty of sexual vice and adulteress. So understand, we know this is really strong words for many people who may not have heard that God actually has stipulations and there is a punishment that comes from allowing ourselves to be given over to sexual
just
vice.
Just like you give your children rules and boundaries,
that's right.
Praise God.
That's
God
right.
gave us rules and boundaries, and that's His word.
Amen.
We stray away from His word, that's what we stray away from the blessings of God.
There you go. Amen.
Let me say that again. I like that
too. Do that.
Okay. If you stray away from the word of God, you stray away from the blessings of God.
Amen. Amen.
Glory
That's
to God.
That's good.
Going to make a t-shirt.
Amen.
Amen. We got to get into the word of God.
That's
the Bible
right.
said, thy word have a hint in my heart that I may not sin against thee.
That's
the word
right.
of God will keep you from sinning against yourself and also against others also.
That's right. That's right. And as we said before, the word of God is set boundaries for our protection.
It is.
These are not rules to follow because God wants to take away our own free will. He created us with free will. He's the one who designed it. The whole idea that we're not just like robots, that's God's design. He created our ability to be just like Him, to be
that's
able
right.
to think and that's create right. and make decisions. That is our, we've been given that as our gift
Amen.
From God. So understand that God is not trying to take away your choices. He's trying to show you what choices are best for you. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like the scripture that says, choose this day who you'll serve. Are you going to serve God
or man?
Or man? Are you going to allow your emotions to dictate, or are you going to please God? Because in that, as my husband just gracefully said,
thank you,
is there is blessing on the other side of being obedient to God.
Oh, there is.
There's always a blessing. God does not give us things to follow and, mm-hmm. and like I said, rules just to stop us from enjoying ourselves.
That's right.
And so understand too that the guarding of our heart is the ultimate thing, that because everything right. affecting your life right now has to do with what's going on in your heart.
Amen. We've got to realize the heart of man is the spirit of man.
Yes.
And realize the heart of man is the spirit of man. So therefore God wants you to obey him in spirit and in truth.
Mm-hmm.
His word is spirit and his truth.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, the guidelines that God has given through his word, we got to obey it.
Yeah.
You know, and the thing is, if we stay in the word of God, we stay under the blessings of God.
That's right. Not the punishment.
Not the punishment.
Yeah.
Once you square away, the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus said, I come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. God wants you to begin to live the abundant life. The only way to live the abundant life is in the word of God.
Amen. Amen. And again, God is trying to bring safety into our life.
That's right.
He's protecting us from those choices that might mm-hmm. take us in a direction that would actually wound us.
Amen. That's totally right, because if we stray away from the word of God, we open for Satan to attack.
That's right.
You know, he's there to try to get you away from the blessing of God and get you under the curse. That God is not putting a curse on your life, but at the
right.
same time, when Satan touches you, it is a curse.
A lot of times we're dealing with the consequences, you know, of our decisions.
Exactly.
And when we allow ourselves to be given into the flesh, and really that's what we're talking about, when we talk about sexual vice, we're saying we're allowing our sexual desires to overcome. overcome
mm-hmm.
what the Word of God has to say.
That's right.
And when you start allowing your emotions to dictate, they lead you in all kinds of directions.
Mm-hmm.
You know, many people think that they can make good decisions without God. And, you know, I've made this choice. I have my free will. You know, after all, I'm an adult. And I know what I want and I know what I need. And then you get out there and you do what you think you want and you need. And then many a time you're dealing with the results of that, the consequences of it. And you don't even realize you can't have a healthy relationship, a long-lasting relationship, because all those issues of your heart have still not been resolved or dealt with
mm-hmm.
because of the choices that you made.
That's right. And God has given us choices. Our choices, you know, and God's choice is just the opposite.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, the thing is, Paul said, I'm crucified with Christ, nevertheless I live, yet not I, but Christ lives in me. And the life I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. As you begin to crucify the flesh and the lust and the desire, see, sin is in your flesh.
Right.
So therefore, what we talking about...
It's in your emotions.
It's your emotion. What we talking about, the flesh, you know, an old King James Version said, the flesh, you know.
Yeah.
The thing is, we talking about your emotions.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot be led by your emotions, because your emotion can change at any time.
Yeah.
You know, your emotion can change it. So therefore, God said, those are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. So it's time to be the new created spirit that God has breathed into you. Amen. You got to begin to strengthen it by the word of God.
Yes.
The word of God is food for your spirit. It renews your mind. You understand? That
yes.
you may begin to have the mind of Christ.
That's right.
So that you may have, you'll be able to obey the spirit of the word.
Yes.
Not just the letter.
Not just the letter. Not
That's
just
right.
law. This is not about law.
Mm-mm.
This is not about you following, like I said before,
we
some
want
rules.
To do the will of God.
That's right. It's
our desire is to do
That's
the
right.
will of God.
Yes.
Because we love him. That's how we show him that we love him. It's to fulfill the call of God that is on our life.
Amen.
Everyone is called of God. Amen. But you don't come to reality of what God desires for you unless you accept his son Jesus, saving Lord, over your life. And once you begin to seek his faith, after you accept the Lord, you seek his faith, he gives you direction and where you should be going.
Yes, in every area.
In every area of your life.
Yes.
Jesus wants to be Lord in every area of your life.
Mm-hmm.
The part is, he's not Lord over the part of you haven't given to him.
That's right. Because he doesn't force his way.
That's right. If you want to make the decision, God wants to go ahead and make your decision.
That's right. Amen.
If you're going to seek God, Lord, what, for direction, He will give you direction.
Yeah. And this is one of the areas that many of us have been guilty mm-hmm. of, not allowing God to dictate when it comes to sexual purity.
That's right.
We have been sold that told bargain deal that they try to give us, that we have the ability to make this choice sexually. We do.
Mm-hmm.
There's no denying that you do have a choice.
You have a choice.
You do have a choice. But understanding this, that being able to experiment sexually does not make you smarter.
Mm-mm.
It doesn't add to you anything. As a matter of fact, most people who are experimenting are dealing with the consequences of their experiment.
That's right. That's
you know, we haven't seen a revolution. The sexual revolution hasn't increased or strengthened relationships. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, it's weakened
mm-hmm.
the monogamous mm-hmm. relationship, as we call it.
You see so much lasciviousness going on in the world now
yeah.
because we're making wrong decisions.
Amen.
You know, God allowing us to make these decisions, but it's not godly decisions. Mm-hmm. It's our decision, inspired by the enemy.
Excessiveness is what he's saying.
Mm-hmm.
Excessiveness. We go to the excess.
Mm-hmm.
We allow ourselves to get so emotionally driven
mm-hmm.
that we just do every and anything,
exactly.
at least that's what we're being told to do, any and everything that we feel.
Mm-hmm.
Your feelings are directing your entire life, but you don't realize your heart is on the other mm-hmm. side of that. So every effect that you have, or every decision that you've made, is affecting your heart. So now your whole life is being directed, as I said before, by those experiences, and those the decisions that
mm-hmm.
you've made have caused you to come up with some kind of ideology,
mm-hmm.
a philosophy of your life, even how you deal with relationships, how you
mm-hmm.
deal with other people. It's affecting everything in our life, and we don't
That's
even
right.
realize it.
That's right.
You know, and God is saying, I want to be in charge of that, or help you take control in according to spirit, so that your emotions won't be so out of balance, you
that's
know,
right, that's right.
Lead you and direct you in a way that destroys you. Remember, there's a way that seems right, and that's
mm-hmm.
the scripture, to a man, but the end thereof is what? Death.
Destruction.
It's destruction. It's destruction, meaning it's going to affect you in a negative way, not positively. This whole freedom we talk about is really not truly freedom. It's bondage.
It is bondage.
It's sold in a package that looks good,
mm-hmm.
you know, just like the apple to Eve,
mm-hmm.
right?
The fruit.
It was the fruit, right?
Mm-hmm.
We call it an apple, but we don't really know what it was. Scripture doesn't say. But understand this, that fruit that she ate seemed good.
Mm-hmm. It looked good, pleasant to
the
eye.
The whole
pleasant.
Sexual revolution looked like, oh, that's freedom.
Mm-hmm.
I got choices. Here, it's going to make
mm-hmm.
me wiser. It's going to make me, but what happened?
Mm-hmm.
Death.
Mm-hmm.
Spiritual death happened, and we don't realize that all these different temptations that are still out there, they're the same one packaged in a different, you know,
nothing new.
I mean, we can call it by some other title, but it's still the same thing.
Same thing.
You know, so understand.
It's a different age. That's all.
It's just a different. Right. That's
different
right.
Age.
That's right. Different generation.
Mm-hmm.
Same sin. Same issue. So we're not really experiencing anything unusual. But understand that God wants us to examine ourselves, allow ourselves to be subject to the will of God, not just by emotion, because when you do that, freedom, true freedom,
mm-hmm.
happens. When we submit ourselves to God, then our choices are made based on truth, not emotion.
Emotion is right.
It's based on truth.
That is totally true.
Because the word of God is true.
That's true.
And it's meant to protect and guard us.
Mm-hmm.
So undefiled, let's understand what that means, because we're saying the marriage bed is to be undefiled.
Mm-hmm.
The meaning means to be pure, clean, holy, set apart, to keep your virginity, that's real plain, or to maintain the monogamous relationship between you and your spouse. So that's what we're talking about when we use that word undefiled. It means to be pure, clean, holy, set apart, to keep your virginity, meaning you do not have to be like everyone else and experiment.
Right.
If you're a virgin right now, you can stay a virgin until your marriage.
Mm-hmm.
If you fell, get back to keeping your relationship pure between you and God, and it's just like virginity to God when you honor Him, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Or maintain the monogamous relationship, and that's speaking to the husband and the wife. Maintain that monogamous.
Amen.
Monogamous.
Don't stray away.
Amen. Between you and your spouse.
Trust me, the grass is not green on the other side.
No, it's just different grass.
That's it. It's different grass. That's all it is. Maintain your grass.
That's right. That's right. You know, it's amazing because many people think that just by switching to another partner, that's going to change everything.
No, you don't change
anything. And all you're doing is changing one set of issues and experiences for another. And I'm going to quote it again, Pastor Billy Joe. You go with you wherever you go.
That's right.
So your issues are still with you.
Mm-hmm.
So when you don't exchange or grow or learn something so profound by having all these multiple experiences, you're not really gaining anything. You're diminishing the unity, what that means. You're diminishing honoring a monogamous relationship. Mm-hmm. And that's why nowadays people don't even believe in getting married.
They're afraid to.
We have watered that marriage bed down to mean nothing.
Mm-hmm.
And now we see the results of that.
One young lady getting ready to get married on my job, and she said, I can't believe it. See, they're living together, right?
Yes.
They're living together. I don't understand how the paper going to really, change anything.
It's called covenant.
It's a covenant. That's all it is, a covenant.
It's a covenant that they're missing.
You're on a blessings from God now.
That's right. Amen.
You know, the sin had been broken off that life now.
That's right.
You understand?
Amen. Amen.
Praise you. You're in a blessing now. Even you don't even have to be saved. Amen. But just get married. You can do the right thing.
Yes.
But to be under the blessings of God, accept His Son and obey His Word.
Amen.
Accept His Son and obey His Word.
Amen.
You know, David said, for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord.
Amen.
As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord.
We will.
We're going to obey the word of God. Because it's a blessing.
And understand this. Again, this is not about law. This is not about rules. This is about relationship.
Relationship.
Just like we want that relationship with our spouse that's so special. And we want that romance, you know, where we're treating each other with honor. And we're, you know, our desire is to please each other. So we want that from another human being. But we don't understand that starts with our relationship with God.
That's right.
In order for it to come to its full potential, we have to understand what the love of God is.
If you're going to let your emotion lead your relationship, it's going to lead you into sin.
Yeah. Because it's only going to go by what you feel.
Exactly.
Because
your emotion is going to always want more.
Yes.
It's not satisfied.
That's right.
Unless it's under the word of God.
That's right.
That's why Paul said, I'm crucified with Christ.
Yes.
You crucify those emotions.
Amen.
You put your emotions on that cross where Jesus was.
Amen.
Amen. Let the newness of life that Christ breathed into you through His death and resurrection be risen up on the throne of your life. Amen.
Amen.
And let Him begin to be, you are now being led by the Spirit of God as you begin to seek the face of God.
Yes.
You'll see the anointing. You see signs, wonders, and miracles happening in your family life. Why?
Amen.
Because you fear God. That we got to get back into the fear of the Lord. The Bible says the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
Yes.
Me and my wife, we see a lot of gifts of the Spirit in operation in our home because we honor God, because we fear Him. You understand? That fear is the respect.
Mm-hmm.
We respect the things of God because God said, be holy for I am holy.
Mm-hmm.
You know? It's time to really sanctify yourself. Sanctification is just another covenant with God.
That's right. We're not perfect.
Mm-mm.
We continue to present ourselves to God.
Mm-hmm.
When you make a mistake, it's not about perfection.
Mm-mm.
When you make a mistake, honor God. Acknowledge the sin. Ask for forgiveness. Repent. That means change your mind. Decide, this is not the way I want to do things anymore. And it's amazing because we can do that.
That's right.
You know, you don't have to keep doing the same thing over and over again. The devil does not control your mind. You have control.
That's right.
Submit to God, and then you'll be free.
Free.
You'll be free. So free yourself from the control of the enemy. Here's the thing. God designed our bodies. He created, he's the author, and he's the designer of our bodies. Mm-hmm. He knew that our desire as a woman or as a man would be to have a relationship with another person. Mm-hmm. And so he created our bodies to be able to enjoy and fulfill that desire. Amen. But he did it within a marriage context.
Amen. Remember now, okay, God brought a woman
to man,
okay? Amen. And man is made for woman. Come
on
now.
That's right.
And woman for man.
That's right.
All right?
That's
that is the marriage union God is talking about.
Yes. That's the one he created.
Amen.
And again, all you have to do is look at the creation of our bodies and mm-hmm. you know exactly what mm-hmm. God created them for.
That's right.
The type of relationship God mm-hmm. created them for.
That's right.
And then understand this. It's sex is not just a physical act.
Go
and
on
I
now.
Think many people have not understood that, and
that's
so
right.
they've diminished it down to just physical. And there's so much more. Remember, we talked about you share DNA. There's mm-hmm. a lot going on in the mm-hmm. physical, but there's so much more than that. There's an emotional attachment.
Go ahead now.
That's that it. Happens within this sexual unity.
Mm-hmm.
It's an intellectual thing. Your mind comes with you. You're
that's
not, you know, you don't all of a sudden check your mind at the door. You know, because this is a choice you've made, so mm-hmm. then your mind had to do that,
mm-hmm.
okay? And then there's an expression. It's an expression of affection when it's in its proper context. There should be an affection, a desire mm-hmm. for that person. There's an expression of affection. Mm-hmm. It's a level of intimacy.
That's right.
This is now me letting you in to me
mm-hmm.
even deeper, okay, in an emotional and a physical way. And then it's covenant.
That's
it's the two becoming one. It's covenant, or as the Bible says, it's that bond.
It's a bond
becoming one. Okay,
mm-hmm. the two
so
become one.
The two become one. So mm-hmm. we understand it's cleaving. That's what I'm looking
cleaving.
For. It's cleaving because it's part of that cleaving process mm-hmm. that the Word of God talks about. The man leaves his father and mother,
mm-hmm.
and he cleaves to his wife. That's in mm-hmm. Genesis 2:28. Mm-hmm. So understanding that. That is the process that God expects to happen mm-hmm. as part of the sexual unity
the
between a husband and a wife.
The sexual unity, you know, part of the cleaving is the sexual unity.
That's right. That's right. And
mm-hmm.
it protects and it's meant to guard mm-hmm. our relationship for any outside relationships.
That's right. And that's why I tell, when we used to teach the class, you know, about the, you know, marriage, we told them to take a year.
Mm-hmm.
You know, take a
mm-hmm.
year, and don't even get a TV. You understand? Spend
yes.
time just communicating with each other and
mm-hmm.
sharing with one another
mm-hmm.
to get to know one another.
That's right.
You know, because why? You're building a new family unit now.
That's right.
A new family. That's why the Bible said, "Leaving, then cleave."
That's right.
You gotta leave. You gotta leave your parents emotionally.
Yes.
Physically.
Financially, yeah.
You understand? A lot of people don't want to lose their, you know, their financing. They're pulling all the time, you know.
Yes, yes.
They, you know, starting because when you just get married, it seems like you got so many bills and what have you, you
yes.
know, and you're adapting to one
something.
Another
yes.
and what have you, you know, and you want to be able. The man wants to be a provider for that woman there,
mm-hmm.
you know. But it takes time.
Yes,
it takes sacrifices.
Yes,
also.
Yes.
You know, you get you now. You're not independent now. You want. Now,
yes.
You got to make that now.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
The desires of your heart, God has already fulfilled.
That's right.
And now he's going to give you the ability to provide
Amen.
For the family.
Amen.
And you're going to become one now. You're becoming one now.
That's right. Like, that means you may not necessarily be able to live as comfortably as you did with your parents.
Exactly.
You know, and people struggle with this.
Mm-hmm.
we've seen several newly married couples that struggle with the financial part,
mm-hmm.
As well as couples who've been married for a while and
mm-hmm.
just never really dealt with this. But you can go back and look at the basics on finance. But understanding that it's a real challenge to break free from, you know, the reliance on parents.
Uh-huh.
If you've ever had that kind of thing,
mm-hmm.
it may be hard for you to establish that unity now between the two of you, establish this new relationship.
Mm-hmm.
The foundation for this relationship is built, and it's going to take you cleaving to one another.
You got to cleave there and begin to pray with one another and begin to serve one another. And part
Amen.
Of serving is the sexual relationship.
That is.
It is.
It's a natural part of the servant.
It's part of it.
Serving of, a heart, of each other in
Bible
marriage.
Should be fruitful and multiply.
That's right.
It's for the enjoyment.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
It's not a sin.
No, it isn't.
Amen. It is a sin only when you begin
take
to
it outside.
Take it outside or divert it and get lasciviousness in it.
Yes. Yes.
You know, so
yes.
That's why men get away from the, men and women get away from the pornography.
Oh, yes. Oh, my gosh. Yes.
It's time to begin to get in, get that word, have a hint in my heart that it may not sin against thee.
Amen.
Because your emotion can be just twist everything.
Yes, yes. It's unrealistic expectations that start to happen.
Your imagination starts to get involved in
everything. Yes, it does. I'm telling you. Mm-hmm. And understand this, again, this is all about guarding your heart and protecting you from being in a situation where you're never being fulfilled.
All right.
So God is thinking about that both in the natural sense and in the spiritual sense. So understand, we want to continue to offer the book to you before and after. We believe it'll be a real blessing for you, especially for Valentine's coming up. It'll be a blessing for you as a couple to go through this book together. You can give it as a gift, as well. The newsletter comes out monthly. If you become a partner with the ministry, we'll begin to start to send those out to you on a monthly basis.
You just sign up
online.
I would like the newsletter. Praise God.
That's
we'll send it out
to you
free.
That's all you need to do. No gifting really necessary, but if you become a partner and you begin to give, we will also send you out a free copy of the book.
Help us get the word of God around the world.
Amen.
This message is time for the body of Christ to begin to focus on their family,
the
marriage unit. We're trying to eliminate the divorce out of the body of Christ. We can do all things through Christ that strengthens us.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right. So get the word out. I mean, God has been good as far as, you know, this year. Now we have a chance to start all over again. Mm-hmm. You know, 2018 can be the best year moving forward.
Yeah. We're pressing forward
Amen.
Now. We're pressing,
Amen.
We can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. We're
Amen.
Pressing forward. Praise
That's
God.
Right.
Somebody may want to come to know Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord. Repeat this prayer out there. It said, Lord Jesus, look on us today.
Look on us today.
A sinner.
Sinner.
In our sins.
In our sins. We accept Jesus.
As Lord. And Savior of our life.
And Savior of our lives.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
For coming to our heart.
For coming to our
heart. And cleansing for our sins.
And cleansing us from
sin. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
And always remember, so that faith come by hearing and hearing by the word of God.
God bless you.